Hey guys, welcome back to Maxim Automation. So today in this video, we're going to discuss about another important feature in spec flow, that is tagging. In the spec flow feature file, you can assign tags to feature and scenarios. Assigning a tag to a feature is equivalent to assigning the tag to all scenarios in the feature file. Spec flow generates categories from the tags provided in the feature file. The generated category name is the same as the tag name. These tags can be used to filter and group the test execution. For example, we can tag our scenario or feature as smoke, regression, or sanity, and then execute these tests based on the requirement. Now let's see that how can we provide the tags. So this is our feature file. As you can see that we have three different scenarios in this feature file, which verifies the price of three different books. The first scenario is to verify the price of Selenium WebDriver book. Another one verifies the price of Java book. And the third one is for C# book. So in this book verification feature, let's add the tag at feature level. You can add the tags by typing the @ and then followed by the tag name. Tag name can be anything, like it might be regression, smoke, sanity, or any other tag based on your requirement. As you might be aware that each time we don't want to run our whole suite of test cases. Sometimes we have to just run a smoke test to test the stability of the product build. In those cases, these tags are really helpful as we can filter out our test based on these tags. Since I have assigned the tag at feature level over here, so all these scenarios in this feature file will automatically be tagged into regression, which means that if I hit the execution based on regression tag, then all the scenario in this feature file will run. Now let's remove the tag from feature level and then assign it to the scenario. Similarly, let's assign smoke tags to this scenario and sanity tag to this. Now we have three different scenarios with different tags. So let's see how can we execute our test cases based on these tags. Open the Test Explorer and build the project to refresh the tag details. Now if you go to the trait column over here and click on the filter sign, then you can see all the tags which we have assigned to the scenarios. If you expand the feature, then we can see the different scenarios with their associated tags. Now let's filter out the tests. And I want to run only those scenarios which are tagged with regression. So you can see that only scenarios is coming over here, which is tagged with regression. And if I run the whole suite, then only the regression scenario will get executed. Now, if you want to run the test, which comes under regression and smoke both, then you can select the checkbox for both the tags. And you will get the list of scenarios which are either tagged with smoke or regression. And if I run the whole suite again, then both regression and smoke scenario will get executed. Okay, so scenario can be assigned with multiple tags as well. Let's say that I want to run this scenario also as part of the regression. So I can assign another tag over here @regression. Now build the project. Once built, then we can see that now we have two scenarios coming under regression. Since the scenario is tagged with regression and smoke both, so the scenario is always gonna run if my test filter contains either smoke or regression. In case you want to execute all test cases, then you can always choose select all filter to run all scenarios. So we have seen that how to do the test execution based on the tags through Visual Studio. Now we'll see that how can we do the same through command line. And to do that, let's open the project in File Explorer. Type cmd over here to open the command prompt. Make sure that you are at the root level of the project. And then you can type the command .NET test hyphen hyphen filter test category equals to smoke. I have given the test category is equals to smoke as I want to run the scenario which are tagged with smoke. So SpecFlow converts all the tags provided in the feature files to test categories. And then these test categories can be used by any test framework to filter the unit tests. So here you can see that only one test case got executed because we have only one scenario assigned with the smoke. Now, if I change the test category to regression and will run the test, then you can see that total test run count is 2 because we have 2 scenarios tagged with regression. Now we'll see that how to provide multiple tags through command line. So first, I want to run those scenarios which are marked either with smoke or sanity. And to do that, add the test category string in double quotes. Then provide the first tag name, followed by pipe sign. And add another test category equals to sanity. So this statement says that I want to run my tests which are assigned with test category or tags as smoke or sanity. Here you can see the total test run count is 2 because we have one scenario tagged with smoke and another one is tagged with sanity. Now, if you want to run the test which contains both the tags, let's say only those scenarios should get executed which contains smoke and regression both. So in that case, we'll change the pipe sign with ampersand, which is an AND operator. And we'll change the test categories to smoke and regression. This statement says that run only those scenarios which contains both smoke and regression tags. If a scenario is marked with only smoke or regression, then they are not going to run. Since the condition which we have added requires that scenarios should be marked with both regression and smoke. So if I run the test, you can see the test run count is 1 because we have only one scenario which are marked with smoke and regression both. Now there is one more option left to filter our tests. Let's say that you don't want to run the scenario which are marked with sanity. Rest all should run. So in that case, you can provide the NOT operator to create the statement, which says run the test cases which are not marked with sanity. You can see the test run count is 2 because we have 2 scenarios which are not tagged with sanity. So this is how we can do the tags-based execution in our framework. Thank you for watching. If you liked it, then please subscribe the channel to get more videos on automation. Also, please don't forget to click on the bell icon. Thank you.